All right, now let's talk about the financial services very quickly and how do they make money in the process. So financial services, predominantly, they are more focused on the fees, unlike banking, which basically makes their money from the interest. Financial services are more focused on the fees, right? So if you have a certain number of stocks, or if you have bonds, or if you have an X dollar of amount being managed by an asset management company, they will charge a certain percent of the fee for managing those things for you, right? So the name of the game there is actually the scale, right? Because they manage, you know, millions and billions of dollars from a variety of different customers. So actually they make a large portion of the revenue via the fees, right? Obviously, there's a commission, which is basically in terms of the trading and the brokerage, forex exchange, and we talked about the matchmaking in terms of you know, some of the premier financial services company. They will be bringing the buyer to the seller, right? So just like a marketplace, but the marketplace for big corporates, where somebody wants to invest X dollars of amount, and there's a company which require the funding, and they will actually do what we call as the merger and acquisition and the advisory and finding the right funding in the capital market or equity or debt funding and variety of different things, right? So that's about the financial services. Last but not least, let's talk about the insurance, right? And we saw that in banking, the main source is interest. In financial services, it's the fees. In insurance, it's the premium, right? So I'm sure most of you would have taken some premium or some insurance, excuse me, in your life. And you know that you have to pay a certain premium on that, right? So if you have a car insurance, for example, you have to pay X dollars per year to really have that insurance, right? And what that insurance is doing is protecting you in case if you need something, in case if you have the misfortune of getting into a wreck and you need to really, you know, sort of like, you know, get your car repaired, and it's going to cost you a whole lot of money, right? So that's where the insurance company is going to come in and, you know, basically help you out with the process, and you have to pay a fraction of the total charges you would have paid otherwise, right? But then the question becomes, how do they actually make money? Because if they are paying much more than what they're collecting on you in case if you have to use it, then how do they actually make money in the process? The idea is they are doing the pooling of the risk, because not everybody is going to require the insurance to be, or basically going to claim the insurance in the same year. But a large number of customers are paying for those things, right? So you have 5 people who are going to use it and 95 people who are paying for it. So that basically drives the economics of the insurance industry, right? Then obviously they have other things in terms of the, you know, the money that they are collecting on you. They do not just have this money sitting in the bank. They actually invest this money and low risk rate stocks and bonds, and they're actually earning the money from there as well, right? They have the fees in terms of, you know, one-time fee or origination fee and stuff like that. Obviously, they also do the cross-selling and the, you know, value-added services. They tie up with different vendors and they actually get miscellaneous commissions and fees from those vendors as well, right? So hopefully this gives you a context of how the money is made in the BFSI industry. On purpose, I have kept it very, very simple, just to really give you different flavors of what are the dynamics, depending on whether it's a banking industry, financial services, or insurance. But they all have something in common. At the same time, they all have something which is very, very different. So hopefully this gives you some context of that. Thank you.